Hi everyone, today we are bringing you a new update on our revolutionary tool, Space Controller. Here are the new features. You can now paste Space Controller automation into Dolby Atmos Objects. You can control the LFE gain inside the plugin. We've also added more speaker layouts and we've made some improvements to the app. So let's take a look at these new features. You can now paste automation from Space Controller to Dolby Atmos Music Panner and also to some DAW native panners such as Pro Tools Panner, Nuendo VST Multi Panner and Logic 2D Object Panner. After inserting Space Controller into the audio track, you just have to add the respective parameters and also the parameters you wish to copy to the panner using your object track. In this case, I'm using Pro Tools native panners, so I have to select these parameters from the list, but if I was using Dolby Atmos Music Panner, I would have to add this instead. Next, we record automation with Space Controller. And then we just have to copy the parameters and paste special to the corresponding parameter in the Pro Tools Panner. As you can see, now it reproduces the same automation I've done in Space Controller. If you want to use Dolby Music Panner instead, you just have to insert on your track and then paste the corresponding automation into the plugin. We know this is not the easiest solution, still we are currently working with some DAW manufacturers to overcome this limitation of plugin architectures, so stay tuned. As we mentioned, now it's possible to control LFE gain in the plugin, and here's how to do it. Just enable the advanced options and then you're gonna have the LFE next to the output knob, and if I play my 5.1 audio, I can now control the amount of output going to the LFE channel. We also added more speaker layouts, including LCR, LCRS, quad, and more immersive formats from 5.1.2 to 11.1.8. There's also some improvements in the Space Controller app. It now comes with 128 available links to communicate with the plugin instances. In the app, we've changed the communication channels to links, and you can select them by clicking in the side arrows or by typing the link numbers of the plugin instance you want to control. We've also added a new option called Stable 0° Elevation. In this case, if the mobile device elevation is between -25° and +25°, the app will keep the elevation value at 0°. If you point above or below that, the elevation will follow the movement. Finally, we've added vibration cues for 5 or 7 related speaker layouts, which give you an haptic feedback when you point the device towards the speaker position. So these are the new features of Space Controller, and if you have more improvement suggestions, just let us know. Send us your feedback on the comments below, and I hope this tutorial helped you find new ways of using this tool. Thanks for watching and take care.